Many of us like spending time in the pub, and some of us probably spend rather longer there than we should. But no one puts in more hours at the bar than the landlord. And the risk is that the pub can take over their life completely.
Hello, Robert. Would you describe yourself and what you do, Mr. Innkeeper?
Very much saved. I had bought this inn for a purpose in my life. Maybe to give something back, maybe to make somebody happy, and to enjoy myself.
Now, gentlemen, good morning.
Robert's been running his award-winning Red Lion in the depths of the Kent countryside for 15 years. Inside is like an old curiosity shop, and the pub attracts customers from miles around.
Tony, good morning.
Hey there, Robert.
Very wonderful.
And at the heart of this successful business is Robert, the archetypal eccentric landlord, supping his beer round the clock.
I'm happy. Excuse me. And making everybody else enjoy themselves.
Hello.
Hi, my darling.
How are you?
Yeah. Still a virgin.
Good girl. What, you or me?
Oh, well, we'll go for it. Oh, you're not going to have a quick one with me?
I've always been a lovable drinker. It's not arduous. It is absolutely such fun.
I'll have a glass of wine, please.
Red or white?
Give us a hint.
I don't know.
Pinot Grigio?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Something a bit sparkly. Think you're on the Italian
Riviera. Like me, really.
Being here when people are all laughing and happy, it does me a lot of... It's like taking... Not that I've ever done it, but like taking marijuana twice a day. But my marijuana is the people who walk through the door and a quick shot.
Quite a lot of pub owners and landlords and barmaids that we've met, they say they won't drink when they're working. This is obviously not a principle that you've embraced.
Oh, lovely.
But you do drink quite a lot.
In moderation. No, I probably do, yes.
How many sharpeners a day do you have, Robert?
Quite a leading question, that. I would say I probably consume 15 pints of beer.
Of a day?
So you're talking about 1.25 pints an hour.
When do you have your first one, then?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock.
Well, I'd say that, yes. I can't tell a lie.
You can't get much fresher than that. Always look at its bottom.
You know it.
No, that's brilliant.
Normally, Robert works at the pub from 7:30 in the morning till midnight, 7 days a week. But a month earlier, he'd been admitted to hospital with a collapsed lung.
That 3-week stint in hospital with a collapsed lung, did it not make you stop and think, just for a minute, maybe I should drink less, smoke less?
Well, I don't drink an awful lot, and I don't smoke an awful lot. So it didn't make me even think.
Robert, you don't think for a minute you might be in denial slightly?
Avidly. Without sans doute.
What would you like to eat?
I would like the squid and then the lamb, please.
May I say, what a good choice.
It's rather like a little kid of one being brought up with, I don't think it happens today, with a dummy in its mouth. So I want to be Peter Pan, still with my dummy. Best have another sharpener.